All right, you guys. Powerhouse Las Vegas, back with my good friend Hide. I just heard recently that Hide was doing the Masters Olympia, so I hit him up. I'm like, Hide, are you competing at the Masters? And he says, yes.
Yeah. I mean, if you ask me 6 months ago, I would say no way. No way. I would never imagine I was going to come back. But you know what? It's accent, but my physique is getting, I don't know why, but I mean, getting better. And so this is put this way, physique first, then I, you know, like my mind came after. So I decided when I was in Arnold Classic, and I was speaking to Johnny Jackson. He's doing it. And he said, okay, I mean, he's 50, I think, 49.
Yeah, he's older than us, yeah.
Is he? Older than me. Maybe I'm
well, around the same age, yeah.
Yeah, but I'll be 50 June.
Okay.
So why not doing it? I mean, I can still do it. You know, I'm not sure if I'm 51, I wouldn't be able to do it. I'm not sure. So now I can do it still. So
I got to say, man, as soon as I found out you were doing it, I started seeing some of your posts on Instagram. And people don't follow him, go follow Hide, because you can see he's been posting some current, you know, condition picture. He looks great. I can't believe it, man.
Right.
We were talking off camera a little bit ago, and you were telling me that the last show you did was in 2020, so 3 years ago already.
Yeah, I mean, that was Olympia, but let me tell you, I was there, but my mentally, I wasn't there. Like, you know what I mean? Like, I wasn't really, I felt like I didn't deserve, you know, to be on the stage.
Really?
Yeah. So last time, I mean, I did it, but I just because I qualified. So that was last show. Then I wanted to do 10, you know, Olympia.
Yeah.
That was my 10th Olympia.
Okay, nice.
So, you know, I just won 10 times, but I did 10 times. Right? Just, you know, step on stage 10 times.
Yeah.
And Masters Olympia came up, and I was, like I said, I would never imagine, because mentally I was, you know, I was like, no way.
Yeah.
It's a whole different game, you know, competing. I was training, but competing is a whole different game. But like I said, the one reason I was getting in shape was my training partners.
Mm.
Here, Dr. George here.
Hey, George.
How are you?
George used to train with the Richie Gaspari.
Oh, nice.
At 80.
90? Oh,
man.
80 me, but yeah, early 90s.
Yeah, you go way back, man.
Late 80s, early 90s.
Awesome.
You know, he knows all the golden era, the golden gym, Venice. And Pedro, he's just moved from California.
Are you living here now?
Yeah.
Oh, shit. Okay, cool. Oh, yeah. All the way from San Diego, man. Yeah, that's awesome.
Then Devin, he's actually
hey, Devin.
Doing all my social media, and he's actually competing this weekend.
Awesome.
Classic.
Good luck, man.
Thank you.
Yeah, first we'll be there. Yeah, first time?
Yep.
All right. So you got a good crew.
Yeah, I got good crew, and then, you know, they push me. And actually, I talking to him coming back to the show, too. So he's doing Masters Nationals in July.
Nice.
So actually, you know, Pedro is, of course, competing again. So we all competing, you know.
So, well, you can't help but grow then. If you train with a bunch of competitors.
Exactly. So this mentality, like if one goes to war, we all go to
that's
war.
That's right. I like it. All right, so we're gonna do some back today.
We're gonna do back, yeah.
All right, cool. So let's do some back, and then maybe we'll chat a little bit more at the end.
Yeah.
Joy, keep it down, this is your height.
I made you
Six. Back up. Three. Five. Four. Three. Right. Two. One.
Let's go.
Bring me a second. You're hitting that. There you go. Let's go.
Pop your chest. Pop it. There you go. Release and explore. There you go.
One more.
See?
Yeah. All right. You're there, yeah. This way?
What?
You go this way?
I'll try. Stick with me.
Okay.
You might have to lower that. I'll lower that. I'll pull it down.
Good. Go. Two. Three. Four. Five. Six. Seven. Eight. Nine. Ten.
You don't have to do cardio with that kind of training, right? It's included in the workout.
This is hardcore.
Yeah.
Bodybuilding.
I know.
Exercise. Man, this one.
That's a lot of
if
reps.
If you do T-bar, you're a bodybuilder. So I wasn't doing this. So I was a bodybuilder.
Really? Yeah.
He was pretending.
I've seen you train pretty hard over the years.
Five, six, seven, eight. One more. This is serious.
It's Olympia, man. Olympia time.
Right. How do you want me to spot if I have to sit?
As long as I see everybody's face. It's great, huh?
Try.
That's the Dorian machine.
You tried?
Yeah.
I think I have, yeah.
Yeah, but it's just perfect size and everything.
Yeah.
Whew. Speak for yourself. Hey. 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 Entonces,
Oh, you did that?
No, okay. Yeah, yeah. Yeah? It's like that when I got there. One, two, three, four, five, come on. Six, seven, eight, nine,
so by so fast. Come on.
Great to have all these variation, so we can create all crazy giants.
So come on, let's go. One, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine. Oh. Yeah. feel it.
Miss Olympia, tell me how you feel about he going back to the Masters Olympia this year. That's big news.
Oh my Lord, when he actually, let me just say this. I pretty much asked him way before he even announced, and I'm blown away that he followed up and announced to me that he's really going to do it when he came back from the Arnold. So I'm very shocked and I'm excited and I can't wait to see what he puts together.
He looks really good already. I mean, we're like, how many weeks are we?
It's 20 some weeks.
He looks great already.
Yes.
He said it was easy, not easy, but he was already like lean. He was kind of like smaller.
Yes.
So now he's kind of just growing back into the show.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely. Growing into it is a better place to be versus having to take off a lot of weight, which is a lot of stress on the heart and the other body parts. So I'm excited.
I know. It makes me feel, it brings that. That competitive edge in the gym again, you know.
Yes.
There's a lot of competitors in your gym, but you know, to have your partner actually, you know, going back to the toughest show in the world is awesome. I'm great.
And I'm looking forward to seeing the other masters that also on stage, because you know, as the years go on, your body mature, but some of them fall off to where they don't exercise as much.
Mm-hmm.
So it's going to be very interesting to see.
I can't wait to see that list. There's no list yet, but
no
I can wait to see it. Well, thanks for having us today and letting us film the. Your partner here at the gym is great. Awesome.
You're very welcome, always.
Boom.
Yeah.
20 weeks?
20 weeks.
Yeah, I don't know if the letters on your back are getting bigger or is your whole back.
It was back day today.
They're easier to read.
How do you feel 20 weeks out here?
Feels good. This I never done. I mean, you know, I kinda reverse diet.
Yeah.
I was skinnier side and grow into the show.
How skinny? So you started training seriously for this contest. You decided to do it a month ago at the Arnold Classic.
200 pounds. So now 210 pounds.
Already?
Yeah.
In 1 month.
And leaner.
Wow, of course.
So I wasn't obviously eating enough. So.
How many meals? So off season, how many meals a day would you eat?
Three
meals?
Three meals. And when I train, I have like a post.
Okay.
So, which always, I always take, you know, whatever, whenever I train.
Yeah.
So, three shakes and three meals. Now, four meals and three shake.
So, seven
so I
meals.
I just add one meal.
Okay.
Sometimes I add, you know, like another one, but normally I eat sport than a shake.
Okay.
But shakes more, I put more, like, you know, start putting oatmeal or, you know, makes it like a, kind of like a meal.
Yeah.
So, but I can tell, I mean, on just one extra meal, you know, I put 10 pounds. So,
yeah,
it should be, so I'm going for 212, so it should be good. I mean, I got 20 weeks, right?
Is that what you're doing, 212?
Yeah, so okay. I'm thinking I pace out. So before I was like always trained and like, you know, just until I feel like I'm just passed out, right? But now I feel kind of 80%. So I sometimes, so last leg workout, I didn't do last set because I felt that was enough.
Yeah.
So I kind of, if I doubt, okay, should I do it, you know, one more set or not? I just don't do it now. I reach a little smarter than before. So now I'm thinking more like a recovery, instead of just going 110% every day.
How do you feel your recovery is this time around prepping versus to 2020? Do you think it's...
2020, I was just doing everything overdoing.
Too much?
Yeah, I mean, sometimes as an athlete, you know, like it's that mentality kicks in and you can't just shut it off.
Yeah.
I mean, unless somebody you really trust
tells you you slow down.
Yeah. Then last show I was kind of doing my own stuff. So for example, I put the lunges, you know, before show. I was always doing lunges before show at the like night lunges.
Mm-hmm.
So I called it for I did it for glutes, you know.
Mm-hmm.
Striations. Iris told me to do it. Then last show, 2020, I was doing like 1.5 hour lunges, like outside every day. Then I was shredded, but I was, you know, like all this muscle was gone.
Yeah.
And I was only 200 pounds.
Yeah.
And I was in a, you know, like a couple years before that, I was barely 212. Now I was like 200 pounds only. So,
wow.
Yeah, I was like at least 10 pounds smaller.
Wow.
Than my, you know, like, I was competing like all these guys.
Yeah, so, yeah.
But this time, I mean, I don't want to say, you know, I'm like mentally same. It's different, completely different. Now I'm more relaxed. You know, of course, I'm doing, you know, I'm doing it for winning, but if I ask me, you like 100% in it, I kind of doubt it. Like, I'm more like enjoying the process.
That's good.
And that's
less stress.
I think that's good.
Yeah, less stress.
Yeah. So then I can put more contents out.
Yeah.
Which helps, you know, this.
Of course.
Yeah, business and this in a part. I mean, not podcast. This show is called Full Time Bodybuilding, right?
Full Time Bodybuilding TV, but, baby.
Yeah, I'm not full time bodybuilding anymore.
Yeah, you are. I saw today. Yeah. You guys are all full time.
Yeah, yeah.
All full time.
Yeah, but I mean, before I was, when I was really competing, I was, you know, that's all I did, right?
Yeah, I know.
I
know.
I lived like a bodybuilder.
Yeah.
Now I have all these business.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Stuff. You're a businessman now.
Yeah, I have like a more appreciate. You know,
yeah.
I have more this opportunity, because before it was you know. Like I thought it was, I took it for granted probably, right? I thought I was always competing Arnold and Olympia.
Yeah,
that was
normal
to me.
Yeah.
For 10 years, but now I appreciate going with this opportunity.
Did you miss competing the last 3 years?
Not really.
Jay says that all the time.
Yeah,
he says, I don't miss it. But
competing part is like, I mean, it should be, I mean, I'm sure it will be fun. I'll be on the stage. But if you ask me, I really miss it. I don't really miss it, but I miss all this like process. You know?
Well, that's what I kind of mean. The preparation.
Preparation.
Yeah, because the competition is just one day,
right.
But it's like 3-4 months of prepping.
Preparation. Yeah.
Yeah. So
I don't know. We'll see. I'm sure.
You seem to be having fun with your buddies today.
Right,
so that's great.
Yeah.
That's a good
enjoying
part.
The process. What he said.
Enjoying
the process. I think what he means by that is that, you know, when we're 100% into bodybuilding, that's all we do. We get so focused that we forget about everything around us. Yeah. And now what he's saying, as we mature, we can kind of be able to differentiate the things and what's, you know, priority, what's not, and we can do multiple things at once. Mm-hmm. But ultimately the show is the destination, and it comes and goes so fast. So the whole idea of bodybuilding is to enjoy the process, and that's why we're doing this into the ages that we're doing it, and we'll probably always do that because we enjoy it.
I think you do appreciate that process more and more as you get older. Not so much when you're younger. All you want to do is compete when you're younger. Right. So you can't wait to be there. You can't wait for that 12 weeks to be over, whereas you appreciate every day with your friends and the journey and all that stuff. But what I was going to ask you is, why did you want to go back on stage this year? A lot of people, we don't know what the list is for the Masters Olympia. So you told me Johnny Jackson is doing it, and I can't wait to see who else is going to be doing it. But what was the reason for you to say, this year I'm going back? I mean, that's three times to be retired is a long time.
Yeah, you know,
even though you always kept training, it's not like you just stopped training. You're always training every day. But what was the reason for you to say, you know, I'm going to go back to the Olympia Masters, and I want to make a go at it and hopefully win?
So to be honest with you, like I said, physique came first, right? So we, you know, train all these great guys, and body just changed. Mm-hmm. And to be honest, like, competition is a tool for me, like, now, because bodybuilding itself doesn't pay me. But this business related to bodybuilding, mm-hmm. so it's, I can put out more content, and I can get more attention using this Olympia. So that it sounds really cheap.
It's a good reason.
So this like social media, you know, time, you have to have good content, and you have to have attention to make business grow, right?
Mm-hmm.
So I have a gym, and I have a body cafe, online,
and you train a lot of people too.
Yeah, then I have Japan shows.
Yes,
like I compete and everything goes good, right?
Yeah,
so I just sacrifice myself.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But when you compete, don't you feel also that everything has to be so structured, your meals, your training, it kind of overflow in the rest of your life also,
right? Yeah.
You seem to be more organized in everything else because you have to be. Yeah.
Exactly. Then this is my first time ever. I mean, when I was in Japan, I was working too. But now, I mean, since I came here, all I did was again bodybuilding.
Yeah. So
that was my job.
Yeah.
Now I do all this.
Yeah.
And between I do like meals and training.
Yeah. Yeah.
So I want to see how it feels like. I mean, I always respect these guys, you know, have regular jobs.
Yeah.
And compete.
Yeah.
I could never imagine I would do it, but now.
You were a full time bodybuilder.
Now I'm, you know, that's the addition. So
that's awesome.
Yeah. But so far, everything good. And like you said, I don't have any extra time, but I enjoy it, you know, like, this is what I love, you know.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
A lot of people are excited about you competing again. I don't know if you hear what's out there, but when people found out you're doing shows, like, people are excited.
I appreciate all these guys, you know, put the comment on.
You have a lot of fans.
Yeah, Instagram.
Yes.
And,
and
I want to show them, like, you know, what we can do. You can be done. Age of 50.
That's right.
Okay? Yeah.
That's right.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Guys, thank you so much for our workout today. It was great to have you on camera. Good luck at your show this weekend.
Thank you very much.
We will be there to watch
it.
You. George, good luck with your show coming up, man.
Appreciate
we may have to film again as you get closer to your show.
Well,
righty day.
You're going
to
be here, right?
Yeah, I'll be around. All right. Thanks so much, guys.